3 days. God was going to raise it up. So here's the, he's talking about himself. He's not commanding them to kill him, but he is in the strongest way making this kind of deliberative statement. And another example, 1 Corinthians 7, someone wants to get married or wants to marry off his virgin daughter, let him do as he wishes. There's an example where this imperative can be translated where it sounds a little more like a just a suggestion. Okay, and the imperatives are simple. I want us to, I got to guys one more here, one more example. Luke 6:37. It is an imperative, and it's not an imperative. It's imperative here, the first use of krinite, and then krithete is subjunctive. You will not be judged in this case will be is a subjunctive. So what is Jesus getting at there? Well, he's not necessarily commanding everyone not to judge, but he's showing the connection between the choice of judging and the consequences that will come from it. If you choose to judge, you will be judged. If you choose not to judge, then you won't be judged, because you're going to be judged on the basis of your same judgment. So that's what's called suggesting hypothesis. The final mood that I want to talk about, and I don't have to talk much about it, this optative mood is very rare. It's used for wishing. In fact, it's so rare I didn't bother making a chart for it, because you're not going to encounter it that many times. In the New Testament, it was almost phased out by the time they were printing or writing the New Testament. Here's an example of how it's used in 1 Peter 1:2. May grace and peace be multiplied to you. And it's an expression of a wish. Is used to express a wish. Another example, 2 Thessalonians 3:16. Now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace. You're going to find a lot of this when you encounter them. You're going to find them in the salutations, in the epistles.
So like a benediction.
Yeah. Well, you're also going to find it in other places. Well,
Galatians 6.
Here's an example of what we call potential optative. Expressing what would happen upon the fulfillment of some proposed condition. Here in Acts 8:31, how can I, in this case, how can I understand what I'm reading? This is the Ethiopian eunuch. Unless someone guides me. And that word guide is optative. So he's expressing a desire for someone to guide him. And that's a good thing, point to bring out. If you're analyzing the text and explaining what it means, that this is more than just saying, oh, well, it's possible for someone to guide me. He's saying, this is what I want. This is my wish.
So he's not being like...
Yeah, it's not an excuse.
He's actually inviting Philip to explain it.
Right.
Okay. That makes the story a little bit more sensible.
Acts 17:18, another example of the optative, when they said, and this actually uses the word wish, but doesn't have to, what does this babbler wish to say? So the concept there is they don't even know what he's trying to say. Okay, those are some examples then of the verbal forms. And that is a complete analysis of almost every weird thing that you might find in the Greek New Testament.